Adding performance tests to a CI/CD pipeline may sound complicated, unnecessary, and sometimes expensive, but that's not always the case. In this video, I'm going to show you how to add K6 load tests to your pipelines using GitHub Actions for free. So here's the thing. When we say performance test, our minds automatically go to load tests. We think of hundreds, maybe thousands of users, a complicated scenario, a dedicated pre-prod environment, and if you're a performance tester like me, a lot of work. But it doesn't always have to be like that. You don't have to run an entire load test just to get an idea of your application's performance. Running a handful of users regularly, say after every commit or every build, will still give you a lot of data about how your application performs over time and across releases. This is called continuous testing, the process of integrating testing throughout the entire development lifecycle using automation tools. So you may think that continuous testing is only for enterprises, but I'm going to show you how I personally use it to automate the performance testing of my own personal little website slash blog. To follow along, you are going to need some sort of application version controlled in GitHub because we're going to be using GitHub Actions as our CI tool. Okay, so this is my website and my blog as well. And this is a simple K6 script that I've got. So we need to change this to nicolevanderhoeven.com, which is my URL. And then we want to look for something that the script will check for to make sure that it's getting the right response. I'm just going to use this developer advocate at K6 part. Just going to paste it here. Let's run it. This will only run for one user and one iteration, but I just want to see what we get. Okay, looks like that worked. And the average response time was 140 milliseconds. All right. Now I want to add some test parameters so that this test isn't just run once for one iteration and one user. I made it a little bit bigger so it should be easier to see. And I'm going to put options here. And for the duration, I think it's probably enough to run it for 5 minutes. And as for the views, let's make it 5. Because this isn't a load test, we're just trying to get an idea. And then I want to add some threshold so that we know whether the test has passed or failed. So I'm just going to put a basic one, which is the duration. And let's say that the 95th percentile should be 95th percentile response time should be less than 500 milliseconds. So now I've committed the K6 script along with my application code in the same repository. So this is the GitHub repository. I'm just going to click on Actions and I'll create a new workflow, which I'll call load test. I'm going to bring up this blog post, which I will also link in the description, and I'm just going to copy what they've got here. So here we're setting what the K6 load test is actually going to do. And I'll copy it here. I just need to change the file name because it's called NicoleVDH. I'm going to commit to this load test YAML file. Commit new file. And it looks like it's updated the repository. Let's go into Actions and there's the workflow running. So what happened is I made a change. The creating the load test YAML file that describes the action itself is a commit, so it's already running on the first go. So the K6 test should be running now too. All right, that's done. So it ran for a total of 7 minutes and 47 seconds. So here we can see the logs for the test, and we see that those virtual users were already running. Okay, so now we've got it set up so that every time I create a new blog post or change something in my website, the GitHub action will trigger and the K6 test will be executed against my site. We could totally stop here, and we haven't spent anything yet because the K6 tool itself is free to use, and GitHub, as of the time of this recording, gives you 2,000 minutes per month for free to use on running GitHub Actions. So there are two reasons why you may want to go into paid territory though. And the first is that maybe 2,000 minutes is not enough for you. Maybe you already have other GitHub Actions that take longer to run, or maybe your scenario, your test scenario, is more complex than the one that I showed here. In those cases, you may want to upgrade your GitHub subscription. And the second thing is, the way that I've set it up here, we would get results for the test that's just been run, but the value of continuous testing is being able to see how performance changes over time across different releases. So you can definitely create your own solutions for that, but if you don't want to deal with a setup, a low-hassle way to tackle this is by creating an account with K6 Cloud. So going back to that blog post, we can also run it on K6 Cloud by changing the YAML file that we already committed. So I'm going to copy this cloud true with the token to the YAML file, so we're changing the GitHub action. Going to actions here. And we're going to edit the YAML file. So I'm just adding the cloud true and the token, which is K6 Cloud API token. To get that token, you need to sign into the K6 Cloud and then click on API token. Now I've already changed this token, so you'll have to use yours, but you copy that. And then that's what we're going to use. So we could just hard code the API token right into the YAML file in the GitHub action, but a best practice is to go into the GitHub repository settings and add that API token as a secret. That way you're not accidentally exposing your API token publicly. So to do that, we go to the repository and click settings. And then you go down to secrets here. And then you create new repository secret. You can see I already have an API token here, but let me just run you through it. So you would put the same name here as we put in the variable in the YAML file, and then you would just paste your API token here and then click add secret. So then going back to our GitHub action, you can just leave this referring to the API token that we've set in the GitHub repository settings. Then we can start commit. There it is. And now it should be running on K6 Cloud using the account that we specified with the API token. So I'm actually traveling a little bit forward in time here because I want to show you more than just one result of the K6 test running in K6 Cloud automatically over time. And this is what that looks like. So the application response time here doesn't seem to change very much because it's a pretty static page, but you get the idea. Ideally, you would see the peaks and troughs here as your response time changes in response to changes in the application. Now we have a low user K6 test that automatically runs every time a change is pushed to a repository, courtesy of GitHub Actions. Automating a performance test in this way makes sure that performance is front of mind for you and for your team throughout all the activities of the development lifecycle. It also is a great way to quantify how user experience is affected by different changes in application code or infrastructure. Now, I talked about GitHub Actions and GitHub in this video, but there are many other CI/CD tools. And if you want to look at others, check out the links in the description below because we do have some other tutorials and resources for those. But I hope this was helpful and happy testing.